I'm Honest Pug.
I'm Lamina.
I'm Patient Otter.
And today we are reviewing the...
Grand Hose from Hookah Store.
Grand Hose from Hookah Store. And it's this big, long one here. As far as our setup goes today, we've got two of the Grand Hoses. And to compare it to, we have an Arbiche. And we're smoking JM's Apple Martini out of a Vortex Bowl, 3 coals. And so that's our setup, and we get on to the review. The first thing is the Grand Hose is most certainly grand.
It's very big.
It's huge.
It's what it does with this if you want it to.
Yeah. It's long, it's big. The gauge in it is bigger around than an Arbiche or a Raisin. So it's incredibly open gauge. What are these retail for, Jeff?
I think like 30, I believe.
Something like that, yeah. So that's the Grand Hose in a nutshell. Let's go to the pros and cons, I guess.
Pros, it's got a really good weight to it.
Yeah.
The gauge is really good. Gets a nice pull off of it. What else? Oh, the mouthpiece is detachable.
It's not
detachable.
Oh, it's not. Oh, okay.
It's a con.
That is a con. Save that for later.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we'll do the cons before I...
So, yeah. It's a nice long hose. And being that it has the handle, I think for a one hose, those are great. For multi-hoses, they not so much. So that's not really a pro or a con. It's just
an opinion type of
a fact of hookah smoking, I guess,
yeah.
Or way they work better. So having a three-hose hookah, having a big handle is kind of a pain. But on one hose, it would allow you to rest this big handle in the nook there. So... Like I said, it's a pro if you've got a one hose, and it's a con if you got a multi-hose, I think.
Any more pros?
Any more pros?
Got nothing.
Got nothing?
I really like the size of the handle. I already talked about that, but...
Well, that's one of the nice things.
It's a good length. It's good for, like... It's good.
I mean, it's like a baseball bat, really. I could have it on my knee and still... I mean, that's pretty long.
Right.
It's making smoking that much lazier.
It's comfortable.
So, I guess...
great accessory to your lazy boy.
Yeah. I guess we get on to the cons. I guess some of the big issues with it is the price. Because it's not washable. And that's a big con. The Raisin, the Narbiche, the Grand Caravan. There's lots of washable hoses out there, and they are all substantially cheaper. And to have a huge hose like this, it's almost a disappointment that they're not washable. Because if these were washable, that would be a huge plus. But... being not washable, that's kind of a big turnoff, in my opinion. What are some of the other cons?
It's just a little bit big and cumbersome.
Yeah.
Say huge again.
So, say huge.
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 Alright,
thanks. One few things I would do differently is... on the base here, the little handle there, have that as an optional thing. Some people like it, some people don't. Have that as an option where you can get it either way, however you want. As far as the detachable mouthpiece, as it is a non-washable, it's not really an issue. If it was a washable hose, then it would be. So that's a...
Right.
So saying, you know, that won't come off is not... No.
It goes back to it being a non-washable hose.
Yeah,
It's the root of the problem.
Yeah.
Like I said, as far as quality goes, it does have a lot of what appears to be hot glue coming out of cracks and things. They're not falling apart, but they do have a lot of surface glue kind of chilling out, and that's kind of attractive.
It is kind of unraveling now.
So is it?
No, this one is a bit.
Because this one's not. I didn't look at that one.
Just a little. Like, I think it will be more later.
See, then
it's new, and it's already got frayed and stuff going off.
Yeah, so when you start talking that much money for this, these become things that you really can't nitpick on. I mean, if it was a $10 hose, you let things go, but when you're wanting $30 a hose, little things like glue popping out.
This is worth more than $10.
So, yeah, I'm saying.
Put that out there.
Well, yeah, it's worth more than $10. What I'm saying, though, is that on the scale of things, the more you pay, the more that you're allowed to nitpick on things.
Sure.
Because, you know, and like I said, if it was this cheap, it'd be like, hell, it'd be the best hose in the market. Because, you know. I guess, I mean, I would pay 20 for them. You know, that'd be a good price. You know, plus or minus a dollar here or there, giving, you know, probably plus, you know, 21, 22. But 30s, you're asking a bit much, because if you want to buy more than one, you know, that adds up quickly.
If it was washable and some of the small cosmetic issues were addressed, it would absolutely be worth $30.
Absolutely.
Because overall, it's a good hose. Yeah. It's got good weight to it.
I guess the only issue or issue I have is the few cosmetic issues with the glue spots and the overly large base handle. Those are really my only issues. And the washable, non-washable thing, I prefer washable, but this is okay. You know, I'll smoke one flavor through it. And
I don't know.
So Justin, can you go over real quick the difference between washable and non-washable, and why it might be a con, or why it might be a good thing that it's non-washable?
Well, I mean, people who have non-washable hoses use them for a flavor, and that flavor builds up authenticity over time. People who use washable hoses can use them for everything, can wash them out, then they get rid of the ghosting. So most people who generally have like a hose, they prefer a washable one because they can smoke anything. Right. Unless you're a person who just smokes one flavor, then, or you smoke one flavor a lot, then you have a hose dedicated to that.
Have you ever tried using just one hose to?
We used to flavor? Way back in the day, but it's since we got washable ones, we just stopped messing with it.
Yeah. God, kid just went double up for, 6 months out of that one hose?
Yep, yeah, he did.
We should have asked him.
Yeah.
That
hose definitely reeked of double apple. That thing, you could smell it from a mile away.
Doesn't it start to smell stale, though?
Yeah.
It would be kind of nasty.
In general, what, 2 months is the lifespan, maybe three for a non-washable? Some people more, some people less. I think it's a personal thing. I think, like, 2 or 3 months is the safe range there.
So $30 once every 2 or 3 months?
That gets kind of expensive.
Yeah.
So like I said, I mean, if it was washable, that would make a lot of complaints go away, I think. Almost immediately. That's the big one.
I don't think we realized when we got these a couple weeks ago that they were non-washable.
We didn't. When we first got them, we thought they were washable.
Did you know
I didn't realize that. I'm one of the guys. That was my mistake there. I should have. To be fair, these are the first generation for these. So.
Well, yeah.
Take that for what it's worth.
But.
For the most part, the issues we have are just cosmetic issues in all reality.
Well, price issue.
Right.
Get down the price. I mean, the hose itself.
But it's well put together.
So. Well, that's my problem. It's too well put together. It's glued all crazy.
Okay, but it's still well put together. It's sturdy. I don't think this is going to... Other than maybe some unraveling, this isn't going to fall apart. This is a decent... This is a decent well put together.
Now, William, I would have as an option or whatever is... The body here, the hose itself, have different colors. So just the beige... For like black or something to match with the rest of the hoses. Or have it like this as one of the options, you know, dual tone.
There wasn't an option.
No.
So.
Yeah, well,
did you choose the color?
Yeah. I think it was like silver and or gold and that. And black. I can't remember what the other one was off the top of my head.
But, I don't know. This first generation, I don't approve of. I think maybe future generations will be good, but I can't say I approve of the first generation. That's just my opinion, though, so.
Like I said, if you prefer non-washables, go for it. I mean, it's... if you like the non-washables, just go ahead and go for it. It's good open gauge, and it smokes well.
So...
What's the grip change in here? What is underneath that's doing that?
I don't know.
That is one of the things I do like is the contour to it. I like the contour.
You can't really see, but it kind of like bumps out and then goes down a little bit.
Yeah, it does have a nice contour to it.
Yeah, it's kind of cool.
But I said overall, just for the price and everything, I can't recommend it. I think that it's a good prototype. I think it's a first generation, and it's exactly what it is, and I hope it does get better, because there's a lot of potential here to be a good hose. I think as it stands, though, I don't think it's up to par. So, anything else? Anything?
Alvin, don't be discouraged. You know, is it? It's a good build. It's a good start. Just work from here, you know. See what you got to do to, you know, to make improvements. I mean,
you're just always solid, though.
Like I said, there's a good potential for O's here. I just think it needs to be tweaked up. So I think we're running out of time. So
Sorry.
Yeah, I've been trying to. But anyway, I'm Mad Wolf.
I'm Honest Puck.
I'm Lenina.
I'm Impatient Otter.
And keep on smoking. Good thing YouTube lets you upload up to 15 minutes now.